Hi everyone, this is Nasser, and I would like to explain a couple of concepts from COM 2-5, Production and Operation Management, from Chapter 3, Demand Forecasting. So there are multiple types of forecasting. The very first one is called naive, and then we have moving average, weighted moving average, exponential smoothing. There are trends, linear trend, non-linear trend, trend-adjusted exponential smoothing, or double exponential smoothing. And then we have centered moving average, where we de-seasonalize our data, and then I'll explain those later. So for now, let's start with naive. I've also actually have a lot more data to work with. I have broken down the centered moving average method. So hold all the steps, so I'll explain it all one by one. Let's begin with our first one, naive method. Okay. The naive forecasting, basically people who do not use software, we don't need even software for that. People who are having their retail shops or restaurants, basically they're the ones that they're using it. So in this one, what we do, let's assume we've started a business, a restaurant, and we are selling pizzas. So, and it's in the month of December 2016. So, in that case, the period is T, the next period would be T plus one. Plus one means future, next period. Plus two, the third period. So, our actual demand. We don't know yet. All right. So at the end of the month, we will get to know how was our actual demand. So at the end of December, we figured out that our actual demand is 50. At the beginning of January, since we only have one data to work with, so our best guess for forecasting January would be exactly the same as last month. So that's the typical definition that is also given for naive forecasting in the book. However, that is not complete. That's part of the equation. Partially, that's true if you have only one point to work with. Like we started our operations in December, and now we're in the beginning of January, so we don't have much historic data to work with. However, at the end of January, so once we reach January, January would become our T, and then December would become the previous period, T minus one. So if you want to figure out what is going to be T plus one, which is our next period, all right, and we also have our January's data, assuming that we are at the end of January and beginning of February. So let's assume in January we figured out that our actual demand was 53. So in order to forecast February, what we need to do is we need to take the difference between the two periods. Okay, so the difference between January, the previous period, and the one before that, December, is 3. So our best guess would be, since it incremented by 3, we assume that in February it will increment again by 3. So we can even do it in our heads. That would be 56. So it would be equals the sum of 53 plus 3. So let's assume now we are at the end of February. So what's going to happen? February becomes our T, January becomes T minus 1, and then December becomes T minus 2, two previous period, and then two periods ago. And then T plus 1 would be our March, our future period. So at the end of February, we get to know our actual data. So let's assume it was 49, the actual demand. So what is going to happen? We do the same thing again over and over. So we take 49 minus January. So you see we were off by minus 4. The change is negative now. So what is going to be our forecast for March? It's going to be the sum of 49 and minus 4, 45. Then what we're going to do, we're going to order whatever we're doing, like pizzas, only 45, not more than that. All right. So it's not necessarily naive method is not exactly always the same as the last period. It is true if you were in January, because you don't have much to work with. So your best guess would be if it's going to be the same as December. However, if you are in the month of February and then you have 3 points to work with, in naive forecasting, you ignore December in that case. You only take 2 points and you take the difference between them and then you simply add it together. Add the same February month as a base, you take its actual as a base and then you add whatever the difference between the actual 2 months are. So in that case, it's going to be 45 for the month of April. The only the biggest drawback we could see is that with the naive forecasting is that we're not using even, the month before that, the December. So the next method we would be, expanding on that because we can't see much variation. It's like very basic and very simple.